I'm your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki. I bring you greetings from Nigeria. This is Word and Wisdom time. And these are peculiar times. And so, I want to send a special appeal to the president of my great country. And I also want to appeal to world leaders, and then ex-presidents and elder statesmen in the country and leaders of thought to help me make this appeal to our great president. I want to speak directly to the president of this great country, President Muhammadu Buhari. Sir, I greet you. You are amongst the first generation Nigerians post-independence. That is to say, your generation were among those who came into leadership within the first 10, 15 years of this great country, to 20 years of this great country. I remember when you were a governor. I remember when you became a minister. I remember when you became a president of this great country. You attained all these positions at a very tender age, just like most of us and most of the leaders of this country. I remember when General Yakubu Gawan got married on the throne. And I remember how much I admired you and Tunde Idiagbon when you came into power. Then I was 24 years old. Now I am 61 years old. I should not be making this broadcast at this age. I should be enjoying my retirement like as you enjoyed your own and came back to become president. Mr. President, sir, you have enjoyed undue privilege in this country just like I did. And you came from the same background like most of us and became president twice. The youths protesting in the streets have never had the kind of privileges that you have had. That's part of the protest, that they want to enjoy the privileges of being in a country like Nigeria that is an oil-producing nation that has so much wealth and so much potentials. They are not even protesting to corner wealth. They are protesting for a right to live. They are protesting for a right for equal opportunities. Do you know when Dangote was recruiting drivers, PhD holders applied to become drivers, trailer drivers for Dangote? Do you know I know master's degree holders who are doing transport businesses, riding Keke Napep in Nigeria? That is not enough. Then they are subject to harassment and punishment. Sir, I appeal to you. I have known you for a very long time. If there is any sincere person around you, it's your wife, Aisha Buhari. Most of those around you are sycophants and parasites. People like your presidential spokesman, they are just doing their jobs. They will even do that same job for your enemy. People like those who came from the legislative arm to visit you recently, talking about opening the economy. The youths have not benefited anything from the economy so far. That's why they are ready to block the economy. One of them that came to meet you took his mother and a group of people to Dubai to celebrate his mother's birthday. Why? Nigeria is not good enough for him to celebrate his mother's birthday. Remember, when you were governor, and when you were president, Dubai was just a fishing port, a small country, that people close to you now go for treatment. Remember, this country has given much to you. But let me tell you, most people are not talking. People like Obasanjo are not talking today. Gowon is not talking. Shoneko is not talking. Abdul Salam is not talking. Because you are not the problem. The problems of this country have accumulated over the years. Even those protesting are not innocent. All of us have contributed to the decay of this country. But you see, a time comes in history when the history of a nation rests on the decisions of a man. That kind of opportunity came to Gorbachev, Mikhail Gorbachev. You remember, you were in rulership at the same time with him. The USSR was a conglomeration of 14 republics. Remember, when Reagan told him, "Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall," and the Berlin Wall was pulled down by youths. There are walls in Nigeria, walls of ethnic division, walls of unsafety. The rich and the elite are safe. The poor are not safe. The rich can go for treatment overseas just like you. The poor will die in Nigeria. If you look at what the youths are doing, they are replicating what they believe should happen. See the way they clean the streets. See the way they feed each other in a classless form. See the way they contributed money for a girl with one leg. See the way they return things that are stolen. You notice that they have organized a protest that was not like the one of my generation that broke car windows and did all terrible things. This is a civilized generation. Mr. President, sir, I appeal to you. This generation, they are not protesting to be fed. You can see them feeding themselves. They are not protesting for jobs. You can see them generating wealth to do whatever they are doing. They are saying they want a right to live a comfortable life just like your children. Just like your children by your first wife and your children by Aisha, a good woman. Mr. President, Mikhail Gorbachev came into power. He was first a communist, but later he became a social democrat. And he changed the Soviet Union, granted independence to several republics, Latvia, Estonia, Nagorno-Karabakh, Armenia, and several states within the Union. Mr. President, you are at a point in history where you can make a change. Remember, you made a lot of mistakes. Remember those two young men you executed when the whole world begged you because the decree was retroactive. Remember those journalists you jailed. Remember the suitcases you allowed to enter the country during the currency exchange. Mr. President, you have started with the right step recently by the Edo State elections that were very credible and well-conducted elections. You were neutral. People who thought they were godfathers, people who thought they were tigers, you did not support them. Mr. President, I appeal to you, like as Ronald Reagan appealed to Gorbachev, tear down this present inequality, oppression, insecurity, pain, poverty, lack, poor health services, bad roads. Tear these things down and build a new nation. Don't listen to your advisors. Don't listen to your ministers. People like Amechi wants to build railway through your town to Niger Republic. Ask Amechi very well if the one he left in Port Harcourt that is hanging up there, whether he completed it before he left. Amechi wants to build a school of transportation in your community. Ask him, what did he do to the school in Okerekonko when he came into power? Ask Joe Igbokwe that wants to organize a 1 million man march. Ask him the community he comes from in Igbo land, whether it is properly developed. Ask Joe Igbokwe when last he got home. Ask Joe Igbokwe what development he has brought in his place. Ask Joe Igbokwe whether he has forgotten Kanu that brought youth earnestly asked for Abacha. Ask him what happened to Kanu. Ask him what happened to Abacha. Mr. President, you are at the verge of making history. Don't miss it. Don't send the army like as some irresponsible people are telling you. It is because they don't want to leave their offices. They are sucking us dry. Their salaries are a burden on Nigerians. Mr. President, you can break down this structure, build a new structure, so that when you leave office, we can celebrate you. We can celebrate you like Muritala Mohammed. You are not just a northerner. You are a Nigerian, and you should be patriotic. Mr. President, don't listen to those around you. A lot of them are just your rear cattle. They are just like cattle egret. They will be picking ticks from your body, doing menial jobs for you, but they don't really have your interest. they don't have a relationship with you. Listen to the nation. Listen to the youth. We've never prayed like this for change in this country. People have never demonstrated like this for change in this country. Mr. President, this is not my generation. These boys are angry. These girls are angry. They have money. They have technology. Mr. President, I beg of you, listen to them. This nation cannot fight another war with these youths and fight Boko Haram at the same time. Don't be the president, Mr. President, who broke this country down, who left in a hurry, just like Babangida left. Mr. President, even the army you want to send, if you check recent history of revolutions in nations, the army have a way of turning against the president. Charles Chesko, in Egypt, Mubarak, in Zimbabwe, severally. Many of the soldiers are also angry. Many of the policemen are angry. Mr. President, I know you. Don't behave like your usual self of not listening to advice. Listen to advice. The nation is at the brink of collapse, even without this protest. God bless you, Mr. President. I believe you will hear. I believe you will act. If you receive this video, please share it as much as possible so that the world will hear and call on the president. God bless you. I remain your friend, Dr. Charles Apoki. Go to my blog. You will see articles I've written over the years. Go to my Facebook page. You will see postings I have made over the years. The world is watching us. President Buhari, sir, don't fail us this time. God bless you.